My name is Joshua Rabang, and I am a second-year radiology resident at the Creighton University program in Phoenix, Arizona. And I have the pleasure of presenting this RSNA case of the week on focal autoimmune pancreatitis. A 56-year-old Hispanic man with a history of hypertension and diabetes was found to have vague abdominal pain, unexplained 16-pound weight loss over the previous 3 months, and elevated liver chemistries. The patient had no history of smoking or alcohol intake. Transverse grayscale ultrasound image through the abdomen shows a hypoechoic mass-like enlargement of the pancreatic head, denoted by the yellow arrow. Figure A, fluoroscopic spot image from endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography reveals a stricture of the involved distal common bile duct, denoted by the white arrow, and upstream dilation of the proximal common and intrahepatic bile ducts, shown by the black arrows. Figure B, fluoroscopic spot image from the same ERCP shows subsequent placement of a CBD stent, denoted by the blue arrow. Axial T1-weighted MR-IV contrast-enhanced fat-suppressed movie clip of the abdomen in the venous phase shows a pancreatic head mass with upstream pancreatic ductal dilation. Axial T1-weighted MR-IV contrast-enhanced fat-suppressed images of the abdomen in the venous phase show, in Figure A, an ill-defined hypo-enhancing mass involving the pancreatic head, shown by the yellow arrow. Also notice the susceptibility artifact associated with the CBD stent, denoted by the white arrow. And in Figure B, upstream pancreatic ductal dilation up to 4 millimeters within the pancreatic body and tail, shown by the yellow arrow. Figure A, axial DWI image of the abdomen shows intermediate to high signal intensity of the pancreatic head mass, yellow arrow. Figure B, axial ADC image of the abdomen shows dark signal intensity of the pancreatic head mass, yellow arrow. Axial T1-weighted MRIV contrast-enhanced fat-suppressed movie clip of the abdomen in the venous phase after treatment with corticosteroids shows resolution of the pancreatic head mass and ductal dilation. There is also a notable loss in pancreatic parenchymal volume. Axial T1-weighted MRIV contrast-enhanced fat-suppressed images of the abdomen in the venous phase after completion of corticosteroid treatment show, in Figure A, resolution of the pancreatic head mass, pointed out by the yellow arrow, and in Figure B, normal upstream pancreatic duct diameter measuring up to 1.5 millimeters and an overall loss of pancreatic parenchymal volume. Axial T1-weighted MR fat-suppressed images of the abdomen without IV contrast after completion of corticosteroid treatment show in Figures C and D loss of the normal pancreatic parenchymal T1 hyperintense signal, shown by the yellow arrows. Lastly, in Figure A, an axial DWI image of the abdomen after corticosteroid treatment shows interval loss of signal in the pancreatic head, and in Figure B, an axial ADC image of the abdomen after corticosteroid treatment shows interval increased signal in the pancreatic head, denoted by the yellow arrows. Our final diagnosis is focal autoimmune pancreatitis. An ill-defined pancreatic head mass and upstream pancreatic ductal dilation, which completely resolved following steroid treatment, favors an autoimmune etiology. Low ADC and high DWI signals, as in this case, are also associated with autoimmune pancreatitis. The collateral findings of an elevated serum IgG4 and histological lymphoplasmacytic infiltrate with positive IgG4 immunohistological stain established a definitive diagnosis of focal autoimmune pancreatitis. Top differential diagnoses. Groove pancreatitis. The classic finding is a sheet-like, curvilinear, hypodense, soft tissue mass within the pancreatico-duodenal groove. Local inflammatory changes and fat stranding of the pancreas and duodenum may also aid in the diagnosis of groove pancreatitis. This is often seen in middle-aged men with chronic alcohol abuse. Pancreatic adenocarcinoma. Pancreatic adenocarcinoma often presents as an ill-defined hypointense mass, which can encase surrounding vasculature and cause mass effect, resulting in upstream ductal dilation. Although the imaging features of both entities may overlap, as in this case, the key is recognizing collateral evidence for the correct diagnosis, such as the physical examination findings, like submandibular gland enlargement as seen in this case, elevated serum IgG4, characteristic histology, and the patient's complete response to corticosteroid treatment. Additionally, the lack of a history of smoking and alcohol intake and normal tumor marker values makes carcinoma less likely. Chronic pancreatitis. This may also exhibit a dilated pancreatic duct. However, parenchymal atrophy and calcifications are more characteristic. Also, a history of chronic alcoholism oftentimes accompanies this diagnosis. Take-home message. Autoimmune pancreatitis is the pancreatic manifestation of IgG4-related sclerosing disease, which can affect multiple other organs, including the bile ducts, gallbladder, thyroid, retroperitoneum, and salivary glands. There is overlap between the imaging features of focal autoimmune pancreatitis, chronic pancreatitis, focal pancreatitis of other etiologies, and particularly with pancreatic adenocarcinoma. A holistic diagnostic approach, which includes clinical history, laboratory values, and histology, is often needed for diagnosis. Diffusion-weighted MR sequences have been shown to be helpful in differentiating localized autoimmune pancreatitis from carcinoma. ADC value is lower, and intravoxal incoherent motion perfusion fraction is higher for focal autoimmune pancreatitis than with adenocarcinoma. A prompt diagnosis is important, as autoimmune pancreatitis is a benign entity treated effectively with steroids, which is contrary to the high morbidity and poor prognosis of pancreatic adenocarcinoma.